So for my last project, I made those GamePigeon Word Hunt, Anagrams, and Dart Spots, right? And then I was challenged by the GamePigeon GOAT, who spammed me over 500 games on iMessage in order to find one of the most high-scoring boards for a competition. Such dedication it must have been to not only navigate the word game screens a million times, but also manually check every single board to find the desirable random combination. So what if I just... well, you could probably figure it out. This is my site, Custom GamePigeon Games, that lets anyone, even Android users, play Word Hunt and Anagrams with close to the exact same addicting graphics and game mechanics. But I didn't stop there. In the customization menu, you can change everything from the language, letter map, timer length, and more. Too broke to afford GamePigeon Plus for 7 letters? Not a concern here when everything is free. You can even go up to 9 letters, or 0. Now let's get into the technology. I used Tailwind CSS to style the menu pages and Phaser.js for game development. Last time I used Phaser was 2 years ago for the Circuitful project. Glad I could still remember how to use it. In general, everything was pretty straightforward to code, especially since I already had a template I could base off and Photoshop the various graphics I needed. Only minor issue was probably the text offset. The generated text for some reason would appear differently depending on the browser dimensions, so I literally had to capture each letter and number as images instead. Wait, I actually opted for a position absolute floating text HTML element for the preview message, display pop-up, and view more words message, but don't really remember why. Perhaps it was better for rapid edits, but in exchange for a not-so-perfect position between device sizes. Oh, and I didn't know what font was being used, so I just stuck with plain Arial. Do go on the site and try it out. Let me know what issues you have with it. I already know the keyboard input for Anagrams is buggy and the board generation might not be the best. But that's because I'm just using a standard letter frequency to randomly assign letters without checking how many words can actually be created. First, I asked chat where I could possibly go to download the dictionaries. Then I wrote a Python program to count up the appearances of each letter of the alphabet in the file for each of these languages. So for example, the letter A appeared 196,667 times in the Collins 2021 English Dictionary Word List, and there was a total of 2,544,396 letters in the entire book. So that makes A have a 7.73% probability of being selected. Meanwhile, the much lesser used small letter U with grave in French appears only once in the lexique. So it has just a 2.94 times 10 to the negative 5th power percent probability of appearing. Consider it an extremely rare collectible. Each of these letterboxes are completely independent from each other, which made writing the board generation program pretty simple. Because before this, I had AI generate lists of words with high potential of forming other words, but it wasn't totally reliable, and even more time consuming was sending myself a whole bunch of games so I can make a list for the generator to choose from. A few months ago, my friend Viet joined me briefly on this project for Hot Packs. We were disqualified anyway since we skipped demos. But also, yeah, next time I promised not to submit a project I had already started before the hackathon. Anyway, Viet's actually a coding node. So he attempted the reverse recursion program to check the largest quantity of combinations for a set of randomly generated word hunt boards. Something that me, the shortcut taker, would never have the motivation for. The idea was to generate, say, 5 random boards, then repeating from each starting point, try to calculate how many total words can be created, following all the possible path combinations. The board that generates the most words would be selected and displayed for the user. He wasn't able to make it totally work, and the letter frequency method used now is pretty decent enough that, well, sorry Viet, but I've commented out your work completely. I like talking about the specific challenges I ran into and how I overcame them. So for example, the locally ran program would be able to directly use the special characters to open file names for foreign languages, but for some reason this would totally not work on the server. Thankfully, easy fix, just had to change all the characters to numbers that correspond to the indices of the alphabet array.
For any interactive elements, I hit a layer of white squares at 0.01 opacity, circles for Word Hunt's diagonal swipes, that disappear when elements are in motion to mitigate potential bugs.
There was also a lot of code involved with making sure sprites displayed with the appropriate scale and position for the window size.
Basically, I would just multiply a scaling factor calculated by the ratio of my iPhone where I captured the screenshot, compared to the size of the current browser window, and another ratio for the original 4 letters mapped to the new customization.
Which is why when I asked the GOAT to be a beta tester, as he knew his thousands of hours of experience would allow him to pick up on every minute difference, starting with the differences in letter sizing.
As for the points incrementing, that was an issue that would only show itself at a high enough level. Originally, my code would repeatedly add a small random amount of points until it reached the goal, but even with a standard increment, the loop seemed to be running faster and faster until update points looked instantaneous. Even when I checked the console printouts, there was still the same number of function calls using the same delay time. After 2 hours of trying various math equations to construct a logarithmic curve, I don't even know what I was doing, I decided to cheat. Exponentially lowering the probability of adding 1 point as the set limit grew gave the illusion of an incrementing animation, while a hard-coded stop after 800 milliseconds ensured that the animation time was standardized for 100, 400, or even 2200 point addition. Finally, of course I had to give it the old bot test. There's also this weird phenomenon on mobile where the image scaling will be fine the first time around, but reload the page and you won't be able to play. So I'm chucking the open source code onto GitHub for one of you more experienced coders to suggest possible bug fixes. I had a lot of fun building the site, from analyzing the game mechanics at a programming level, all the way down to even the most tedious tasks, like manually exporting 80 individual characters for the Japanese alphabet. I'm eternally grateful for myself for using a program to convert the entire dictionary to hiragana, because there's absolutely no way I manage another set of katakana in kanji? You bet for Mandarin I'll be relying on alternate writing systems. I hope my site brings joy to you all, from those who didn't have access to GamePigeon, to the word game pros who can hopefully save time now with a new training tool. I'm always looking for ways to increase and improve the features, so do let me know your feedback via the contact form. If you can, please help support the developer, so I can keep creating and sharing free resources.
I'm hoping to implement a way to challenge a friend. You can see that I'm already working on adding other languages. Absolutely not. No more distractions, because somebody has 4 finals next week and has been writing the script to procrastinate studying. So I better say goodbye now. Thank you for watching.